Hey guys, welcome to the Living Minerals Guide here at Rune Runners. Basically what we're going to be doing is gaining living minerals. We're actually going to be killing enemies and mining them. I don't know if you've done this before, so bear with me. I'll start with the very basics. For this, you're going to need the best armor possible and your best weapon possible. We're looking for a fast rate of attack with decent damage, which is why I'm taking the whip. I recommend definitely taking a combat bracelet, which will be explained why later. And a ring of dueling. You can also take an amulet of glory, teletabs, and similar, obviously, armor types or teleport types. And the reason for this is because we want quick banking for a quick return. You also want to take the best food possible. Don't forget your pickaxe. You'll see why. So, whack out your combat bracelet and head over to the monastery, and I'll meet you there. Boom, there we go. Right, now you want to head straight over towards the Dwarven Mine. You don't need to use the combat bracelet. You can just walk here if you prefer. You can also get here through the Dwarven Mine of Falador. It's a bit more of a walk, but it's another option. Show you where we're going down here. You should all know this. If you're following such a guide, you should know this. I recommend a very high combat level for this. Cool. So once you're in the mine, just head over here to this dungeon icon, and we want to go across this rope. Proceed regardless. Let's do it. Cool. Right, now we're here. We have Living Rock Strikers. Now these are fantastic foes. Good experience. Good monsters, good experience. So we'll just attack this, and as you can see, quite a lot of health, very good armor. Just wait for this guy to die. Now what these guys drop are noted. So they drop noted adamant ores, noted coal, noted minerals, and charms. These kind of drops, they're cool. You know, they're very good, obviously, when you stay here for a long time. What makes it even better is that once he dies, you can mine him using your pickaxe, which gives you living minerals, which are quite valuable. And seeing as everything stacks, I can often leave here with 5 million in my bank if I stay here for a weekend, log on 10 minutes here, 20 minutes here. This, you know, over a month. If you're that kind of guy who really wants to make money but you don't get the time, you get 20 minutes, 30 minutes here. This is a fantastic thing to do for your money. Right, he drops. Now he drops a gold ore and a gold charm, noted obviously, and you can mine him. Once you actually mine him, you just have 45 living minerals here, and they will pop up. 54. Okay, so I just got 9 from that. Just eat one of my monkfish, take that. Eat another monkfish, take the gold ore. Right, it's not a lot of ore, but it all adds up once you've been here a while. Now that just dropped 9, so if I add 9 in, I'll show you what that kill was worth. Just coming down on that kill was worth 3.7k. Yeah, so I mean, this was 2 minutes earlier, and it can just show you how much money you can make from this. So we'll just carry on. You also have another foe here, Living Rock Protectors. Lower level, obviously, worse experience, worse drops. Technically, I haven't got anything to prove that yet. But you can take that on your own opinion. They don't hit very hard, they don't hit very high, but they do hit quite often, which can be a pain in the bum. Now, to mine these, you need 73 mining to get down here. There's no requirements to attack them. There's no requirements. Just, I recommend a high defense level and high strength level. And at least at a minimum 40 attack for rune equipment, rune scimitar, I'd recommend if you're at that kind of level. But the highest strength and highest defense possible, if you're going to range them. I mean, I wouldn't have high range defense. If you're going to range them, go for it, give it a shot. No harm there. And you can also mage them, there's no harm there. That actually hits quite high. I can't remember their weakness off the top of my head, but I'll leave a link onto these for Wikipedia. So if you just go on the description below and click the link for Wikipedia. Okay, this one's taking a long time to die, which is a bit of a pain in the bum, but it's worth it. And I really do love the noted drops. It's a great benefit, great advantage to actually killing these guys down here. Just mine him out, see what we get. 54 to 60. Okay, 6 there. Oh, would you look at that? Nice little bonus there. Try not to bring too much food if you've got a high level. Let's have a look what wiki's for. Fishy. Oh, decent. Yeah, they respawn quite quickly. Now, what you can use living minerals for, if you prefer, is to grab a fishing rod, come down, and you can fish down here for rocktails. Now, rocktails sell currently about 1.2k, 1.1k, I believe. So, obviously, rocktails are worth a lot more than living minerals, but I believe you require 90 fishing to actually catch them. And these guys are aggressive. There is a world for rocktail fishing down here, so obviously you get attacked a lot less. So if you're coming down here to fish, head over to that world, you'll find it on the activities list, and begin fishing. Just kill this guy, and let's pretend we've been down here forever, and go on my banking method. Come on. I believe these now to be better than green dragons. They're underpopulated. It's just casual, it's a nice chilled out way. 70 there, again 10 from that, which is about 3.4k, I believe. Take my oncoming. So everything's noted, which is the best part of this place. Everything that's dropped is noted. So, stackable, so it's nice and easy. Now, let's say we've been down here a while, we've run out of food, we've got a nice amount of items, and we've got a good collection of loot. We want a bank. Well, this is my preferred method, is straight over to Castle Wars and use the chest there. It's a nice handy way of doing it. And it saves a lot of walking, which makes us happy. Just use the bank chest over here. Sorry, excuse me. Fantastic. Bank away. And then once you're ready to go, combat bracelet to the monastery. Hope this has helped you out some way. If you have any questions, post them below. If I've missed anything, please post it as a comment. If you're not viewing this on YouTube and you're actually on the website, you can actually contact us at info@runerunners.com. Thank you very much.